flora, those fantastic trees that help with the excess of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The pretty flowers that are the men's ultimate calming weapon against women, next to chocolate, which is also produced from plants, and therefore by extension can be considered a salad. Those wonders of nature are beautiful, helpful, and deadly. In short terms, nature is out to kill you, be it flora or fauna. And Konami, in its infinite wisdom, decided to mix together carnivorous plants and deadly animals. Enter Predaplants. The Predaplant archetype was introduced in Invasion Vengeance booster pack all the way back in November 2016. The cards, used in the Arc 5 anime by the antagonist Yuri, didn't play a role in the meta at the time. Not until May 2017, when the new wave of support came out in Maximum Crisis. That's when the Predaplant engine was introduced and took the meta by storm. It was used almost instantaneously in pretty much every deck. This was the combination of the cards' availability, the cards needed from the engines were commons and rares, and what the engine did. The sole purpose of this engine is to search a card, as this engine searches out a fusion card or polymerization. If you're wondering why it was so strong, then let me show you this. Brilliant Fusion. As one of the best fusion spells in the game, having a way of searching it was obviously extremely powerful. Although with Brilliant Fusion first getting limited and then banned, the engine fell out of popularity, finding its place in fusion-centered casual decks. With almost no more impact on the meta, it was quickly forgotten. However, with the introduction of Predaplant Vertae Anaconda, the Link monster, in Dual Overload, the engine got its second wind. Or maybe a dying gasp. As things are now, the engine still provides searches for fusion decks and also helps with summoning their Link monster. These are four cards. Triple Predaplant Orphis Scorpio and one Predaplant Darlingtonia Cobra. For additional consistency, it can be expanded to additional free copies of Lone Fire Blossom. The biggest pro of this engine is that it provides two plant-type monsters on the field, which can be used as either a rank 3 Xyz materials or as Link materials. Providing polymerization or a fusion spell also is a quite good benefit. In most cases, the engine uses up the normal summon from the turn, and also it requires one monster to be discarded in order to search the fusion slash polymerization spell. The cards it searches are also limited, and it can only be used once per duel. The usage of the engine is limited to fusion-based decks like Fluffles, Predaplant, Gem Knights, and Red Eyes. Well, no idea about the latter two, since those have an archetypal means of searching a fusion spell, but I digress. Well, that'll be it for today. I hope I wasn't able to install in you my irrational fear of plants. For the love of God, take this away from me!